You may have probably heard about all those different fad diets, each promoting its own way of improving health and body composition. Paleo proponents, for instance, follow the diet of the ancient cave-dwelling ancestors. Vegans do not eat meat, and ketogenic dieters prefer a low-carbohydrate diet. But who's true? Well, let me tell you one thing. There is no one-size-fits-all diet plan that works perfectly well for everyone, and that could be the reason why you're not losing weight. Studies have shown that people can metabolize the exact same food in very different ways, which means a diet that works for you may not be suitable for someone else, or a food that's perfect for your body may make another person gain weight and feel lethargic. The worst part is that many of these fad diets promise you instant results by making you believe many awful dieting myths that hinder your weight loss efforts. In this video, I'm going to debunk 5 commonly believed dieting myths and unveil the truth for you with facts and science. Coming up. It is very important you understand the concept of energy balance, which is the relationship between the amount of calories you eat or take into your body through food and drink and the energy your body uses or expends. A calorie is a measurement of energy. 1 calorie is the amount of energy it takes to heat 1 kilogram of water by 1 degree Celsius, also called a kilocalorie. According to the law of energy balance, if you want to lose weight, you have to eat less energy than you burn. That is, you are in a negative energy balance or in a caloric deficit. If you want to gain weight, you have to eat more energy than you burn. That is, you are in a positive energy balance or in a caloric surplus. If you want to maintain your current weight, you have to eat more or less the same amount of energy you burn. That is, you eat at your caloric maintenance level or simply your total daily energy expenditure. So no matter how clean your diet is, if you feed your body more calories than it burns, you will gain fat. And no matter how dirty your diet is, if you feed your body less calories than it burns, you will lose fat. Thus, in a sense, a calorie is a calorie regardless of where it comes from. As you see, the law of energy balance defined by the first law of thermodynamics dictates whether your weight is lost, gained, or remains the same. And the fundamental rules of dieting must be based on it. Food does not make you fat, overeating does. Eating french fries or donuts does not make you fat, but overeating them does. There is nothing specific in certain foods that make you fat. All foods are broken down in the same process by the digestive system into 3 main macronutrients: protein, carbohydrate, and fat. The amount of calories in food is determined by the amount of its macronutrients. Hence, it is not about eating certain foods and avoiding others that will make you control your weight. It is more about manipulating your diet in a smart way. Remember the law of energy balance. What's so bad about carbohydrates that makes people believe that low-carb diets are the best way to lose weight? The contention seems over insulin, the hormone produced by the pancreas, which is responsible for shuttling excess nutrients to the fat cells. The belief is the more carbs you eat, the more your body releases insulin, and hence, the more it will store fat. Which means, if you want to minimize fat storage, you want to minimize insulin production, and low-carb dieting is the best way to accomplish that. Well, this is wrong, because although insulin causes fat storage, it doesn't make you fat. Overeating does. Remember again the law of energy balance. Besides, several studies portray the superiority of low-carb diets over others for weight loss, without realizing that it's actually the high protein, not the low-carb content, that is offering the weight loss benefits. If your protein intake while dieting is inadequate, you will end up losing your muscles, your basal metabolic rate will drop, you will burn less calories during workout, and your fat and carbohydrate metabolism will be impaired. When protein intake is matched between low-carb and high-carb dieters, there seems to be no significant difference in weight loss. Low-carb dieters also claim that they lose weight faster. This is true because when carbs are broken down, some are converted to energy, while rest is stored as glycogen in the liver and muscles, which pulls water along. So when you suddenly reduce carbs in the beginning, a large amount of water will be flushed out of the body, causing rapid weight loss. However, this is only short-term water loss, not fat loss. In the longer term, There's little evidence that low-carb diets are superior than others in fat loss. Not to mention, some people don't go well with low-carb diets because they feel lethargic, mentally clouded, and weak over the long term. Given that carbohydrates are the human body's primary fuel source for workout, and that they play a key role in muscle building and recovery. This winds them up in gaining back the weight they lost once carbohydrates are reintroduced into their diet. The verdict is simple. There's no one best way to lose weight. As long as you keep yourself in a caloric deficit, you lose weight regardless of the dietary protocol you follow. While crash diets may help you shed weight rapidly initially, they aren't sustainable in the long term, and it's very common to put the weight back on, eventually setting you up to failure and disappointment. According to the American Academy of Family Physicians, weight loss in crash diets is largely from lean muscle and water, not body fat. Crash diets also come with serious side effects and may harm your health. They sometimes cut out entire food groups, which may cause nutritional deficiencies, leading to osteoporosis and bone fractures, dehydration, kidney damage, anemia, nerve and muscle malfunctions, and irregular heartbeats. They cause lack of energy, making you feel irritable, tired, and lethargic. They slow down your metabolism, making your body produce more of the hunger hormone ghrelin and less of the fat storage regulating hormone leptin to cope with the fewer calories. And they may lead to more serious emotional disorders such as binge eating, yo-yo dieting, anorexia, and bulimia. Every time you eat, your digestive system breaks down and processes food, which expends energy and stimulates your metabolism. This thermogenic enhancement, which constitutes around 10% of your caloric intake, is known as the thermic effect of food. So logically, if you eat more frequently, you will keep your metabolism on fire the whole day and burn more fat, right? Not so fast. Studies revealed no difference in 24-hour energy expenditure between low and high frequency eating. In other words, whether you are nibbling small frequent meals, which will cause slight increases in your metabolism, or gorging large meals, which will cause longer boosts in your metabolism, will both lead to the same energy expenditure at the end of the day. While few studies showed that frequent feedings can cause an increase in thermogenesis, many others simply failed to prove it. Hence, the body of evidence simply does not advocate increases in metabolism as a result of eating frequent meals. Have you fallen into any of these myths before? Have you ever followed a diet that failed you? Let me know by commenting below. Thank you guys for watching. If you like the video, please like and share. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. If you're looking for a complete self-educational training guide that teaches you step by step how to customize your workout and meal plans using science-based methods to help you achieve the best results, please visit my website or check the video linked up. Also check my next two videos on how to accurately calculate the calories you need to burn fat and how to fix a skinny fat body.